Several years ago, on a cold, rainy fall morning, that was when we first met Bob. We were on our way to go get something to eat, and I yelled across the water, "Hey, you need help?" And he immediately just said, "Yes." So, not expecting that, I had to stop and turn around, and we went over, tied off to their dock, and helped get the boat righted. Apparently he had explained that during a storm a couple weeks before, he had the boat in a lift, but the water on the lake had risen to the point that it floated off of the lift and he didn't have it tied off. So it drifted across the lake and was discovered a few miles away up on the rocks. This caused some pretty bad damage to the underside of the hull. And he had towed it back with his little personal watercraft. So once he got it back, got it put up on the lift, it had so much water in it that the lift itself couldn't raise it up any further. So he had tied off the bow eye to the dock. But then we had some more rain and the water level went up a little further. And that actually caused the boat to slip out of the lift, capsize, and kind of go under with just the bow sticking up out of the water. We were able to get it flipped over and get it lifted enough with the lift that it wouldn't roll on us again. And then Bob was nice enough to take us to lunch. We were kind of on our way there before we had met, but he went with us, and as cold and wet as it was that day, we went slow to keep the rain off of us and shivered the whole way. We got there, we ate. After that day, Bob had invited us over to his house for a Halloween party hosted by him and Terry, his girlfriend. And from there, there were, you know, other events and other parties. But while we were on our spring break trip to Port Aransas, we learned that Bob had passed. When I spoke with him before, he had inquired as to whether or not we wanted to take his boat and two personal watercrafts in the event that he passed. When I went to examine the trailers, I realized that those vessels were on the dock for a long time.
Welcome to another edition of Fixin' Stuff, where we believe if you buy it, you break it.
You put a little WD-40 on your bearing.
Needs a lot of work. The wheels, tires, I don't know about the axle. All that's in bad shape. Lights are broken, probably don't even work anyway. All that's gonna get rewired and replaced. We're gonna repack these bearings. We're gonna slap some paint on it, and I'm gonna put some nonskid on the front parts of the trailer you're stepping on while you're loading and unloading in the water. And then we're gonna undercoat the axle mounts, the frame, and kind of get it ready for whatever conditions.